cause the cash ain't gon' come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a f- for us? So instead of making it hard, I made it fun for us. Make it easy, so when you need it, you just run to us. But it's a lot of pressure, I'm trying to stick and move through this. Fixing these bumps on the road so I can just cruise through this. Living my life on the road, I'm trying to get used to this. And when they throw dirt, I just act like a broom to this. Trying to stay true to this. Even when they lie on me, world on my shoulders, my girl can't even cry on me. God watching over me, the devil probably spy on me. I've been going through some, can't have keep an eye on me. I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture, don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire, I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see a bite of me. I'm sorry. To all my supporters, man, I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. These don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach. This is Thursday Night Football on EA Sports. Up next, we've got what should be a great matchup between the New England Patriots and the Pittsburgh Steelers. I'll see you again at halftime as we preview some of the action coming up on Sunday. But for now, it's Thursday Night Football. And on the call, as always, it's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, at Heinz Field. Moments ago, a scene that's played here since 2004. Big Ben Roethlisberger greeted by the sold-out Heinz Field crowd. His Steelers getting set to match up with Tom Brady and the New England Patriots. With Charles Davis.
Brandon Godden. Charles, we look at this Steeler ball club entering play, and I don't think from what we saw down on the field before the game there's any doubt they're ready to roll.
They pass the eye test, don't they? This team looks fired up and ready to play.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Patriots, an early season tilt. And when it's an early season tilt, should be ready to roll.
Well, let's face it, the aches and pains haven't really set in yet, and both teams eyeing a really good start to get things going.
This is James White, and he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down. And now we take a peek at the Patriot offense.
But well, we all know that Rob Gronkowski is one of the premier tight ends in the NFL, but what makes him that way is the size. We see that. The ability to run, he's faster than a lot of wide receivers. The agility, he's almost like a power forward in basketball. Ball and the competitiveness. When that ball is released, he decides it's his and no one else's.
Sony Michel, his first carry. And he stopped immediately there. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Throwing is Brady on 3rd down. It got his man complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Philip Dorsett, 68 yards. And the Pats have taken the early lead.
We thought they may be a quick strike offense this season. That is lightning quick. Not bad for the first drive of the year.
That has to actually exceed expectations, doesn't it? Because most teams want to be a quick strike offense. They want to score as quickly as possible and run a defense into submission. What they have to understand is, while they got it done there, long way to go. Don't get discouraged if you actually have to run a few more plays on your next drive.
Bullock good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. So out come the Steelers now for their first drive. They're led onto the field by a man who needs no introduction, Ben Roethlisberger.
We talk so often about his physical attributes. Of course, the Big Ben nickname, his ability to take hits in the pocket, his ability to extend plays and get outside of the pocket. But how about this for efficiency? Top 10 in career NFL passer rating. He's one of the top 5 winningest quarterbacks in NFL history. That's pretty darn good.
Over the middle here to Brown. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 7, and it'll set them back for 2nd down.
There's so many things that can ruin a game for an offensive lineman, but defensive tackles at the line of scrimmage, at the point of attack, who can make you miss and get upfield and make plays like we just saw there for big loss of yardage, those are the guys that ruin games for you, because they're not just lining up and you're able to hit them right off the line of scrimmage. They can make you move and make you miss, and then you have plays like that. I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
But that's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it.
From here, this would have been a 48-yarder, but no, they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it with Roethlisberger. And this is caught. He hits Macklin. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. They're able to keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one.
Well, peel back the curtain, partner. We've got a pretty good look into how they plan to play this game. Aggressive seems to be the word. Going for it on 4th down in that situation.
Yeah, opening drive. Now, we know this coaching staff, they have traits of aggression in their history, but what a start to this game. They're going for it.
Yeah, a lot of people might say reckless, but they got it. 1 for 1 on 4th down here early in the game.
23 yards on the play. So they gave up the early touchdown. This has been a pretty good response. Nice drive, taking it down first and goal.
And I know all the cliches jump in, right? Don't get away from your game plan too early. Make sure you're settled down. Don't panic. But it's all true, isn't it? Because otherwise, you get out of what you plan to do during the game, and it's still early. Don't get crazy because you gave one up. Just respond, as you just noted.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Orleans Darkwa taking it in. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordero Patterson. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Bud Dupree, a former first-round pick, in on the stop.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else he'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Third down, Brady, and Dwayne Allen on the ground. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
Obviously, they didn't get everything they wanted on that completion, but they put themselves in a spot where you've got to at least think about going for it. I know where we are on the field, but still, you've got to think about it, don't you?
The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown, and now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They got it. They got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
On second down, Roethlisberger. And McDonald here over the middle. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now a first down carry by Bell. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, it's Bell. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Now, after the run by Bell, here's another first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Now they'll throw it with Roethlisberger. His throw caught at about the 5. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
He'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, 2 already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Now the Patriot offense set to take over again and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Brady and the Patriots now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now a play fake. Brady. Over the middle. Dorsett. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First play of the drive, a success. 19 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route.
By 20!
Throwing on first down is Brady. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
Well, there it is, partner. Brady to Gronk, their first connection of the game.
You think those two often in sync?
I don't think there's any question about it. And look, we know Gronk has a whole lot of fun, but he's deadly serious about his football, as is Tom Brady. Two great competitors, two fantastic players.
T.J. Watt in on the tackle.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. To throw on third down, Brady. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
On second down, Michelle. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
I think Cameron Hayward's ability to take on blocks, hold the point of attack, and get upfield serves him very, very well. What a nice play there.
Yeah, he can take on blocks because he's built like a block. On third down, Brady. And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Philip Dorsett, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. He's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Oh, the return is Henderson. And a good return up past the 30, but was it aided by an illegal block or a hold? Let's see.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
So that will push him back.
First down.
And now we know why I have a little extra space to run, don't we? The legal block in the back, that penalty will move them back.
So the special teams penalty costs some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. Throw left side, complete to Smith-Schuster. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. A reminder coming up at halftime, it's the season debut of the coach, Jonathan Coachman, in Orlando as we look ahead to all the action coming up this opening weekend. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both of these offenses having their way so far, so maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game? Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, and they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back. But that's one step in the proper direction.
Go, An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now with the play clock down to two, we're going to get a timeout here, as he'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
That one goes for 24 yards. First down now, but that clock rolling. Brady now on first down. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Pernell McPhee. Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Well, this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long.
Like 20, 380, like we get.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 13 yards on the pickup, and that's going to lead to a third and 12. Shotgun now for Brady. And able to find Conley. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Brady now closing in on a 200-yard first half through the air. It's first and 10. Throwing now is Brady. This is White on the screen. Gave a glimpse of his quick feet, but not a whole lot of space down at the 30. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. It'll be a 47-yard attempt from the left hash. And Bullock will put this one through. So we have reached halftime here in the Thursday night opener. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, good to get another season underway. We'll get back to you guys for the second half of the season opener. But first, let's take a look at what's still to come here in the opening weekend of the NFL season. Good matchups all up and down the schedule there.
All right, we will save the week one highlights and apparently get right back to the action here in the third. Bullock out now to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
Now Ben on third and long. He's going deep for Brown. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but there must be a little bit of the Madden curse going on for our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
Now fair catch is called for and taken at the, we'll call it the 37-yard line. Yeah, call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Patriots take over. So Brady and the Pats take over first and 10 at their own 37.
Wait 20!
They'll start the drive with a give to White. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. A gain of 3, second down. Brady to throw on second down. Over the middle, open is Thomas. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Holding offense.
That's a good chunk of yardage that's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in the game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books. But now they have to make that up again, don't they?
20!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. They get 6 yards back on the run, but still have a third and long situation forthcoming.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
20!
To throw on third down, Brady. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down.
Pass interference, defense.
Some boos coming down right now from this home crowd after that call.
Yeah, and that was because of the pass interference call, but for a second there, I thought maybe they'd gotten a look at my appearance as Othello in the high school play.
You were Othello?
Not a good one, let me tell you.
And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Wait, 20!
On play action, it's Brady. Going for the deep ball. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Morgan Burnett. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
They'll try and get the running game going with Bell. Up past the 25 to the 26, a gain of 5.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Brown. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Roethlisberger hooking up with Brown to get the Steelers a first. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to
Now he'll be wrapped up around the waist and pushed down. These strong safeties, some people may not realize it. It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in him on that play emerged.
Now it's Roethlisberger. Danny Shelton in there to get him. And this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays. Well, you don't usually get a sack from a nose tackle spot, but we got one there.
No, we don't. And a lot of the times in passing situations, they end up off the field anyway. So how happy was he to work his way back to the quarterback and put him on the ground? He's going to have to put a nickname after something like that, some big jelly or something like that.
Off the play fake. Here's Roethlisberger. And he's got his man. That's Macklin. A big 30-yard play on third.
Well, they just treated third and long as simply an opportunity to make an even bigger play. Normally, you're just trying to pick up the first down, and you know where the sticks are. They took this thing way downfield. Confidence in the receivers to go up and make a play, even with defenders around them.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down, so let's see what this is about.
Holding offense.
Would have put him in the lead.
Still third down.
That thought.
Yeah, the celebration had to stop, didn't it? Because now you're on a real uptick. You're in the lead. Instead, you're still behind. Have to find a way to regroup.
On third down, Roethlisberger finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he's taken down inside the 30. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
And I know you can't really see it, but that play spells frustration with a capital F for the guys on defense. They covered everyone else, end up going to the running back out of the backfield, and he picks up a back-breaking first down.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess.
Now Roethlisberger to throw. Goes underneath for Bell. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down. He's having a big game through the air, and sometimes those smart decisions just dump it off. That's how you continue to have big games through the air.
I agree totally. That's a great analogy, a great way to put it, because he doesn't get too greedy where everything has to be pushed downfield, trying to create big plays that aren't there. You dump it off and take that nice gain, and things add up, and now you have the kind of game he's having.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
It's a loss of two, now third down.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stop.
Back now in Pittsburgh. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. And the Steelers on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 7. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. That's complete right around the 8. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to 4th down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, You're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And Fairbanks will put this one through. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net. But they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell him, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. They go play action here on first down. He's going to air it out for Dorsett. And this is taken in at the 5. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Philip Dorsett with now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And the Patriots have moved out in front. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
A field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal.
Wait, 20!
They'll run for it with Bo Scarborough. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. Bo Scarborough taking it in from a yard out. And the Patriots have moved out in front. Solid job up front, really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. On the return is Henderson. And an excellent return there as he's up to the 35, but make it the 40-yard line.
And when you're facing a deficit on the scoreboard, you're just looking for something to get you right back into the game, and that's the spark that they were looking for. They got it with that big return.
Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at the 40. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
To the right side, and he's got Macklin complete. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. This is Bell on the dump off. Call it a gain is 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now Roethlisberger. And this is caught, Jeremy Maclin. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Now Bell. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right. You look at the numbers. Neither side looks on track in the ground game.
He's going to get it running right. He pushes forward for maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rush just tee off on your quarterback and makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Able to hold him to just 2 yards, and now it's 4th and goal.
Well, they were successful in one sense. They completed the pass, but still leads them to a tough 4th down situation, doesn't it?
It does, and the deficit more than 3 here at a 1-score game. So the field goal. Got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Jeremy Maclin from 4 yards out. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Big 4th down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on 4th down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this 4th quarter. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Well, that throw by Brady, incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, 2nd and 10. A give, this is Michelle. And some room to work. A nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up.
I thought that was a good call. Passing situation on 2nd down, they hit him with a draw instead and pick up nice yardage.
Yeah, because the draw, they're thinking pass when they see that initially defensively, right?
Well, you know, in today's NFL, most of the time on 2nd and long, when it's a passing situation, pass rushers are on the field and they're only thinking one thing, get to the quarterback, and oftentimes you can bypass them with a running play.
20!
They'll try and run for it. Here's Michelle. And he's going to have the 1st down at about the 38. Whistles now in a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the 2-minute warning.
Here's
a 1st and 10 at the 38. Now a play fake here on 1st down. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset.
And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now Brady. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down. To throw is Brady. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. I guess you can't be afraid to take those chances late in the game. He tried to fit that one in there. Nice job, though, defensively.
But to your point, it was a nice job of knocking the ball away. But you're also right. You can't be afraid to take those chances. That means your guys going downfield to catch the ball, they've got to elevate their game and come down with these in order to keep your offense moving.
Back to throw, Brady. Looking again for Thomas, this time complete. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Brady to throw. He's got a man. It's Mitchell. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Malcolm Mitchell, 38 yards, and the Patriots have moved out in front.
Hey, that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. And I'm looking at the clock, and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off. Now, on the other sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practiced the two-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before, and if you haven't, you just have the confidence, hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Getting set to go again, Ben Roethlisberger marches onto the field. This is something we've seen many times over the course of his career. Can he pull off another fourth quarter comeback?
It's very strange, isn't it? Because when it's a player of this magnitude, even though the guys on defense have the lead and are sitting in the best spot, they're maybe the most nervous people in the stadium because they've seen this happen to too many people before, too many teams. They've got to find a way to shut him down.
Here we go again for the grizzled vet. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. He's back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee.
America's most, ain't no half step, and see you at the crossroads.
Money over on my head, stop.